Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's talk about multiplicity in proton NMR. To understand the idea of multiplicity, we first need to understand the idea of neighboring or vicinal hydrogens. We'll call vicinal hydrogens or neighboring hydrogens N. Vicinal hydrogens are attached to an adjacent carbon. We have on the screen a Lewis structure of chloroethane. Chloroethane has two different types of hydrogens. The hydrogens on the CH3 group on the right, and the hydrogens on the CH2 group. The CH3 hydrogens are attached to a carbon. The next carbon over is an adjacent carbon. The adjacent carbon has two hydrogens. Therefore, the hydrogens on the CH3 group have two vicinal neighbors. We would say N equals 2. Similarly, the hydrogens on the CH2 group have three vicinal neighbors. For these hydrogens, the CH2, N equals 3. Now that we can count vicinal neighbors, we can learn more about multiplicity. The multiplicity for peaks in simple molecules is equal to N plus 1. Multiplicity equals N plus 1. If N equals 0, no vicinal hydrogens, multiplicity equals 1, and the peak will appear as a singlet. If N equals 1, multiplicity equals 2, and the peak will appear as a doublet. If N equals 2, multiplicity is 3, you'll observe a triplet. N number of neighbors is 3. Multiplicity will equal 4, and we will have a quartet. If N equals 4, multiplicity is 5, we will have a pentet. N equals 5, multiplicity will be 6, that's called a sextet. And if N equals 6, multiplicity is 7, and we will have a heptet. 6 vicinal neighbors is about as high as we need to go. Great. What do these different multiplicities look like? Okay. How are the multiplicities different in a spectrum? The singlet multiplicity of 1 is a single line. There's really not much to talk about in the single line. The doublet multiplicity of 2 is 2 lines of equal intensity. Again, not much to talk about there. The triplet is 3 lines with a relative intensity of 1 to 2 to 1. The middle line is twice as high as the end lines. The quartet is 4 lines, and it has relative intensities of about 1 to 3 to 3 to 1. The pentet is 5 lines. Going to approximate that there. It's 1 to 4 to 6 to 4 to 1. The sextet, the intensities are 1 to 5 to 10 to 10 to 5 to 1. The heptet has 7 lines, and these get really difficult to draw in a meaningful way. It is 1 to 6 to 15 to 20. I'm not going to write the rest. It's in 15, 6, and 1 going back down. Okay, these follow a pattern called Pascal's triangle. Impress your friends by sharing that on Twitter or Facebook. Okay, let's see 2 molecules to reinforce these ideas. Here again is chloroethane with its spectrum. The CH3 on the right has 2 neighboring hydrogens. N equals 2. So the multiplicity is equal to 3. The CH3 hydrogen should appear as a triplet. They do, and it has a relative intensity of about 1 to 2 to 1. Furthermore, we have a CH2 group. The CH2 hydrogens have 3 neighboring hydrogens, N equals 3, multiplicity is 4, a quartet with 4 lines, relative ratio of 1 to 3 to 3 to 1. Great, let's move ahead. Here's chloropropane. The CH in the middle has 2 neighboring CH3 groups. That's N equals 6, multiplicity equals 7, a heptet. And here is our heptet. You can barely see the ones on the end. there, and that has a ratio of 1 to 6 to 15 to 20 to 15 to 6 to 1. All seven of those lines represent one signal, the signal for the H of the CH group. The two CH3 groups, which are identical, appear as one signal. Those hydrogens all have just one neighbor with a multiplicity of 2, therefore a doublet, two equal intensity lines. So now we've seen multiplicity. Based on the observed multiplicity of a peak, we can determine how many neighboring hydrogens are present. This is useful information for piecing together a molecule.